chairperson and chair co-chair. I'm very thankful to Dr. Harish for organizing such a wonderful program. Or I'll be talking about oral nano ketamine formulation for the effective treatment of depressive disorder. This is, I think, wonderful slide made by the WHO that why there is a need to know about depression. It is a hidden burden and it affects around 350 million people worldwide. Most of them are women. I welcome Professor Saeed for coming and joining us. Thank you. So if you look at this slide that the WHO has said that there is a need to understand depression because it is not only it causes morbidity but mortality. Look at the around 1 million people, to be accurate, 0.8 million people commit suicide and most of them are suffering from depression. So if you look at this slide that up to 70% of the treated cases do not respond to women to the common conventional medication. So therefore, given the high failure rate of antidepressant, the proposition for better understanding antidepressant men is a question. So there is a dire need to develop such a drug, and we tried to get something like esketamine from America and the technology we could not receive. So therefore, ketamine is administered intravenously since long time for the purpose of anesthesia. But now it has a very promising. So then we thought to why not to develop oral ketamine because until now there is no such available medication in worldwide. So we, because this is a safe method and higher potency compliance and non-invasiveness and easy to counter overdose and adverse effects. So then comes to the nanotechnology. I think most of you are aware, but for the newcomers, nanotechnology is a field of research and innovation concerned with designing drug which is around 100 times smaller than the actual size. So, and it can be used to many things like forensic thing, electronic, drug delivery, agriculture, and so on. So then we try to develop formulation that is used to administer therapeutic substance in the body to control manners and ensure safety and effective delivery of drug. So for that purpose, importance of effective drug delivery formulation. We thought that the drug should not go throughout the body, starting from the liver, reaching to the target area. So we thought, why not to use drone technology type method? So in this way, the objective was to investigate the developed and potential of oral ketamine formulation as a novel treatment for medication. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when we started this project, the ethical committee did not allow us to go directly to the human being because it was such a high potential. So therefore, we started in the initial phase to work on the animal studies. And with HEJ, at Karachi University, we started this project. So the approach adopted in the current research to achieve the objective to overcome challenges, SNED was formed. And SNED is basically, I'll explain, SNED is basically self nano-emulsifying drug delivery system. This we made. Is a specific type of drug delivery system that spare the other part of the body reaching the target area. And the target key feature are the thermodynamic stability, improve absorption of the poor soluble drug, and it offer potential for target delivery to specific tissue or cells. I don't want to confuse you regarding the mechanism of these NETs, but I'll try to see. So what we did, we prepare ketamine loaded NETs, and then we put it into cinnamon oil, tweens and other things, and we compare all the formulation. So here you can see the drug solubility was mainly very good we achieve with the cinnamon. As you know, cinnamon is a commonly the herb which is used in our country and it's useful. So therefore we choose that one. So you can, if you feel if the snet size and the zeta potential and other things, so in this way it was having a very good potential to carry the drug. And this is the morphology ketamine, because we want to show that the world that it is actually being done in the HAJ. So the animal study we started, and we compare the animal study on rat model. And in that you can see that different dose was started, starting from water to ketamine 0.5 milligram, then 2.25 milligram and 0.5 milligram. In that way we developed this. And this Skinner box test was performed on all of the them. So it was with very good result. You can see that the results are very good for 0.5 milligram per kg. Then we again, another test was performed, the four swim test, which is one of the most commonly used assay for the study of depressive-like behavior in rodent. And it is used for evaluation of antidepressant drugs, antidepressant efficacy of new compound and experimental manipulation that are aimed at rendering and preventing depressive-like state. So the nanoparticle formulation was formed, and so that it can deliver the drug to the target area where it is required at the synaptic levels. So the antidepressant activity of ketamine load zinc oxide nanoparticle was very good. And this is the liposome drug delivery system, which is very complex to understand, especially for the clinician. But some of you are sitting, I know, Dr. Saima, she has done PhD with me. She is able to understand this. So the advantage of liposomal drug delivery system was that drug is protection, target delivery, enhancing drug solubility, bioavailability, and sustain and control drug release and reduce side effect. So this ketamine correlation curve, you can see that the encapsulation of the efficacy of ketamine loaded liposome formulation was calculated by given formula. So this was the characteristics of the drug-loaded liposomal formulation. And so now in conclusion, ketamine is an anesthetic that is used to treat depression. Due to its short half-life, frequently doses are required. So there is a need to develop a sustainable release formulation for ketamine with higher load and to evaluate the in vivo pharmaceutical efficacy. So that in this way we develop formulation tested for antidepressant activity in animals, and the present data suggests therapeutic effect exhibited by ketamine formulation. So, and the dose that was very useful was 0.5 milligram per kg. So the promising result were obtained from that, and the efficacy was very good. Further clinical trial of ketamine could be conducted to understand the various other aspects of psychopathology of condition. So I acknowledge this work, because this was not single-handed, and there are multi-sectoral things were coordinated, and especially I'm thankful to Professor Kausar, who is now working in Germany and in UK, and Professor Raza Shah, who is the top scientist of the country. इसको जो है ना तावरामान स्विट्जरलैंड से लाए हैं, और इसका 1700 इंपैक्ट फैक्टर है जो पाकिस्तान में किसी का भी नहीं है. तो आई एम आल्सो थैंकफुल टू द तलत रूमी हु इज वर्किंग इन डीएच डाओ यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हेल्थ साइंसेज एंड बीएमएसआई पीपल. And let's hope for the best, and jazakallah khair for your attention concentration.
I think first we'll open the hall for the question answers, because we had three talks and they were very interesting. So all the audience in the hall, they are given the time to ask questions from the esteemed speakers. So Professor Iqbal Afridi is here, Dr. Naiza could not be here, the other speaker is also here. So if there are questions from these two speakers, please feel free to ask the questions.
Anyone for the question?
वैसे तो बहुत अच्छी प्रेजेंटेशन थी प्रोफेसर इकबाल अफरीदी ने जो भी लास्ट की, इसके बारे में ज़रा मेरा ये सवाल था कि केटामीन जो है वो इसकी सेफ्टी के बारे में क्या है कि हाउ सेफ इज केटामीन टू ट्रीट अ पेशेंट ऑफ डिप्रेशन.
अच्छा, इट हैज़ द पोटेंशियल ऑफ एब्यूज, बट दिस इज स्मॉल क्वान्टिटी एंड द आंसर इज लाइंग हेयर that there are certain contraindication that psychosis is totally ye jo hai isme nahi de sakte, to humne pehle hi se isko rakha hua hai ki aise cases nahi rakhenge. You are very I'm thankful that you asked this question because andhadhun nahi de sakte isme. To otherwise jo humne formulation banayi that is very potent but safe as well, because aur badan se guzrega nahi, seedha target delivery pe jayega.
Acha. अच्छा, थोड़ा सा मुझे अभी कुछ तीन चार दिन पहले एक पर्सन फ्रॉम कनाडा आस्क अबाउट दिस कि वहाँ पे वो ये यूज़ कर रहे हैं केटामीन एज अ नेजल कोई
एस केटामीन. वो हमने टेक्नोलॉजी मांगी नहीं दे रहे थे, फिर हमने अपनी बनाई तो पता चला कि वो उसमें भी प्रॉब्लम था, नहीं दे रहे थे तो फिर हमने अपनी बनाई. ये हमारा सारा जो है इसको पेटेंट कराएंगे तो इंशाल्लाह इसमें बहुत सारा हम पाकिस्तान में ज़र मुबादला कमाएंगे.
ओके, ठीक,
थैंक यू.
ठीक है.
अच्छा, ये आप लोगों को हम दे रहे हैं, इसमें एडिटोर उस बंदे का है जिसके साथ मैंने काम किया है ना. दे दे, डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं आपको कि डॉक्टर रजा शाह जो एक्चुअल ऑथेंटिक किस्म का वो है जिसकी 1700 इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर है.
दैट्स अ वेरी नाइस टॉपिक. और इसके लिए मैं ये कहूँगा कि हर इंसान की कामयाबी के लिए रेजिलियंस का होना बहुत लाजमी है. और मोस्टली हम जितने भी लोग किसी भी प्रोफेशन में आगे निकल आते हैं इन डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज़ में, तो दो ओनली फैक्टर रेजिलियंस है जो हमें अपनी जो हमारी सलाहियतें हैं उनको बरूकार लाने में या आगे लाने में उसका बहुत बड़ा रोल होता है. एंड टॉक बाय प्रोफेसर अफरीदी साहब वाज वेरी इन्फॉर्मेटिव. ये डिप्रेशन की ट्रीटमेंट में बहुत बड़ी एडिशन है जो सर ने चीज़ें बताई, और क्लिनिकली जब यूज़ होंगी पेशेंट के लिए ज़्यादा बेनिफिशियल हैं और विद लेसर साइड इफ़ेक्ट्स, तो आई थिंक दैट विल बी अ गेम चेंजर. सो थैंक यू.
बहुत इंफॉर्मेटिव जो है ना टॉक थी, और काफ़ी सारी लर्निंग की चीज़ें थी, ख़ासतौर पर साइकोलॉजिकल रेजिलेंस के हवाले से. अगर इसको मतलब हम टेक्निकल चीज़ों को ज़रा दुरुस्त कर दें तो मेरा ख्याल है कि उनकी लास्ट तक वो प्रेजेंटेशन नहीं चली थी, तो अगर इस चीज़ को नेक्स्ट वाले सेशन में ठीक करा दें. ठीक है, यही मुझे कहना है. थैंक यू.
प्रेजेंटेशन उस पर तो हमने डिस्कस भी कर लिया. दूसरा, ये ड्रग एडिक्शन वाली जो प्रेजेंटेशन थी, अब ज़ाहिर है उसमें हमारे पास वो क्वेश्चनेयर भी नहीं आया, तो मेरा अगर हम देखते तो फिर हम सवाल करते कि वो जो क्वेश्चनेयर आपने बनाया है तो वो कैसे, मतलब कहाँ से लिया है, उसका स्टैंडर्डाइज था नहीं था जिसमें आपने दे दिया. तो बहरहाल अब वो आपकी प्रेजेंटेशन अगर आप बताना चाहें तो आ जाए. प्रोफेसर उनेजा न्याज का वो तो चीज़ लिव इन लीजेंड और बहुत सीनियर हैं. वुमन मेंटल हेल्थ पे जितना वो बात करती हैं मेरे ख्याल में वो सबको पता है, और रिलेवेंट चीज़ें थी उसमें. तो ओवरऑल उसमें तो कोई सवाल बनता भी नहीं है. पोस्टपार्टम प्रीमेंस्ट्रुअल और सारी जो भी वुमन है मेंटल हेल्थ से रिलेटेड थी, तो आई थिंक दिस इज़ माई कमेंट.
मैं सिर्फ ये ऐड करना चाहता हूँ कि ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द पैनल ऑफ चेयर्स वी आर वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू डॉक्टर हरीश फॉर इनवाइटिंग अस हेयर, एंड ऑल द बेस्ट टू डॉक्टर हरीश फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. आई थिंक टिल दिस टाइम इट्स ऑलरेडी अ सक्सेस हैविंग सो मेनी पीपल, एंड आई एम होपफुल दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द अदर्स विल जॉइन बाय द इनॉग्रल एंड टुमारो. सो ऑल द बेस्ट हरीश.
वी वुड लाइक टू वेलकम प्रोफेसर सईद फारूक साहब हु इज ट्रेवल ऑल द वे फ्रॉम यूनाइटेड किंगडम एंड प्रोफेसर जावेद अख्तर हु इज ट्रेवल फ्रॉम बन्नू एंड अवर सीनियर मोस्ट फिजिशियन इज हियर डॉक्टर शत्रुघ्न सो आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल अपॉन ऑल द प्रेजेंटर्स टू कम ऑन द स्टेज एंड रिसीव देयर सवेनियर्स फ्रॉम अवर वर्दी चेयर पैनल्स एंड अ गेस्ट सर प्रोफेसर सईद फारूक साहब We want you to come on the stage, please, sir. Dr. Javed Akhtar Saab. Sir, please. Sir, Shatrughan Saab. Who is going to receive award on behalf of Professor Oneza Niaz? Dr. Chandra. Dr. Chandra. I'll take it myself. Okay, I'll take it
myself. I request all the chairpersons to please present the shield to Dr. Mishal Ashraf. Honorary shield is being presented to Dr. Mishal Ashraf by the chairpersons of this session. Now, I request Dr. Muhammad Iqbal Afridi Saab, sir, please come on the stage and receive your honorary shield from the chairpersons of this session. I request Dr. Shatrughan Saab to please present the shield to Dr. Muhammad Iqbal Afridi Saab. I request Dr. Shatrughan Saab to please present the shield. Now I request Dr. Sir Haresh Kumar Makhija Saab to please receive the shield on behalf of Dr. Oneza Niaz. I request Dr. Haresh Saab to please receive the shield on behalf of Dr. Oneza Niaz. I request Dr. Shatrughan Saab to please present Ajrak to Professor Irfan Saab. I request Dr. Shatrughan Saab to please present Ajrak to Dr. Professor Irfan Saab. I request Dr. Motiram Saab to please present honorary ajrak to Dr. Sayed Farooq Saab, Professor Dr. Sayed Farooq. Now I request Dr. Manzoor Jamali Saab to receive the honorary ajrak from Dr. Haresh Kumar Makhija Saab. I request Dr. Dolatram Saab, sir, please come on stage and present the honorary ajrak to Dr. Manzoor Jamali Saab. I request Dr. Ghulam Rasool Rin Saab to please come on the stage and present the ajrak to Dr. Jamil Junejo Saab.
Dr. Ghulam Rasool Rin Saab, please come on the stage and present the ajrak to Dr. Jamil Ahmed Junejo Saab, who is the chairman of Department of Psychiatry Lums. No, I would like to call Dr. Zainullah Kakkar. Dr. Zainullah Kakkar Saab, who has traveled from Quetta, please come on the stage and present the ajrak to Dr. Ajmal Mughal Saab. Dr. Gordon Das and Dr. Umar Murtada Saab, please come on the stage. Sir, please.
I request Dr. Gordhan Saab to please present the Sindhi cultural thing, topi, to Dr. Murtada Saab. Request Dr. Motiram Bhatia Saab, please present the Sindhi cultural thing topi to Dr. We are witnessing the amazing moments of this conference. We have all the seniors between us. We are really thankful to them.
I would like to call Mubashara Tayyaba, President of Young Psychological Association of Pakistan, to come on the stage and present the Ajrak to our senior most physician, Dr. Shatrughan Saab.
I would like to invite Dr. Neil Vadwani to present the Ajrak, Dr. Zainula Kakkar.
Please. अनिल साहब जब से IBS में गए थोड़े स्लो हो गए.